वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरद्विषे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो अज्ञाविहीन अपराधलक्ष्यै चेत्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गः कृपामयि त्वं शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणा
जय गुरुदेव।
Please to me,
sprinkle your mercy. You are queen of Krishna. You can give Krishna. And in the midway, in the meantime, oh, he saw, oh, nearer, oh, Shanti put there. So many coconut trees are there. In Vrindavan, no coconut tree. And, oh, smiling Advaita Charge, coming with fire wash and door coping. Mahaprabhu, oh, where am I? Whether I am in Vrindavan or Shantipur now? Oh, he said, you are in Vrindavan. I am seeing angels? No. In this side, Jamuna, and that side, you are in Vrindavan. Then Mahaprabhu was here, like, oh, tricky persons. They have brought me. And he took bath in Jamuna, Ganges. And they took away to Shanti, very near there. And there, oh, Nityananda Prabhu invited his mother, all Navdeep Vasi, all the persons of Navdeep, and here and there, left and left, devotees, assembled there. His mother came, weeping, weeping, weeping. Mahaprabhu was also. And he fell, he kept his head on the lotus feet of mother. Told, oh, I have become mad. I have no intelligence also, just the I have done wrong. I took sannyas in magic. Please be merciful to me. Please allow me that I should again come in your household life. With you? Then mother weeping told, no, no. I want only that. Oh, you should be renowned. And you should carefully follow this path, what you have taken. But I want only that you should be nearer to me. You should not go to Vrindavan. We cannot see you if you are in very near in Puri, or sometimes you can come to take bath in Ganges near Navadvipa. Sometimes all devotees will go there, meet you, and your good and anything news, oh, I can see. So I will be happy. So you should be in sannyas life, and you should go only. And in the meantime, a boy named Raghunath, the son of a high aristocratic family, like king, at the age of only 16, he came. He was so much known to all, because he was a very religious person from boy. So all used to love him. And he came to Mahaprabhu, very beautiful, like prince. He told Mahaprabhu, I want that you should take me with you to Puri, where you are. I want to serve you for whole life. I don't want to return my home. That what Mahaprabhu told. Oh, you are not now mature. You should be mature. So return back to your home. And what I am telling you should do, you should keep your behavior, very sweet behavior to your father, mother and all others, and keep bhakti inside your heart. Don't let it come out. Bhakti is like a canker. You will take out and so, oh, I have so much bhakti. Oh, see, I am so much. I am chanting so much. I am doing so much. Then bhakti will go like that. So try to keep it very secret. So he told them, oh, don't talk any worldly talks with him. Don't hear at all. And always chant and remember Krishna. Don't take, oh, very delicious foods. And don't mix with any bad association. Always chanting the name. And keep it very secret. Then, when you will be matured, oh, Krishna will arrange that you will come. So don't be that. Nowadays we see that those who are not matured, no? They went to their Gurudev. They were initiated, or they are inspired so much, always serving in this, that. But when he left this world, what became? All the matured persons, they returned back to them. At that time, all brahmacharis, no marriage, nothing, one contact in the service. But yet they have so many desires. So Mahaprabhu told that you should not come, but from there you should practice bhakti yoga. And when you will be matured, don't know fear to others. So, and then he met to Nityananda Prabhu, it has been told that story. And then Sachi Mata told that you should be here 3-4 days and I will cook you and you should take. So he used to make preparation. What? Shark, which grows in jungles automatically. Or laptop engine. Very beautiful, tasteful. Anna, dal, and all the preparations. Mocha ghanta, loud luck lucky and so on. Very beautiful proposition. And offered to his deity, Narayan. And he used to give to Mahaprabhu. And Mahaprabhu used to give. After 3 days, ten days there. And after 10 days, he became so cruel. More than anyone, cruel. All were weeping, and he left all. And he started for Jagannath. Oh, he was at that time mad. What singing in the way? Krishna, 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 hey. Krishna, Keshava, Krishna, Keshava, Krishna, Keshava. Pahima, Aram Raghav, Ram Raghav, Aram Raghav, weeping bitterly. Oh, so many devotees were with him, not so much, but some were there. Like Gadadhar Pandit, like Jagadananda, like Mukunda, like Nityananda Prabhu. Prominent, Chandrasekhar perhaps. So many were there. And they were in the way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has gone for begging or taking bath. And in the meantime, Jagannanda has the dand of Mahaprabhu, pure dandasha. And then Jagadananda Pandit told that I am going to bake something for all, so keep it very careful. And he gave it to Nityananda and he went. And what happened? Nityananda Prabhu is talking with Tanda. Oh, my dear Tanda, why you are in the hands of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Supreme Personality of Godhead. No need that he should catch you here. I am carrying Mahaprabhu in my heart and he will carry you. I don't fall. And then he took that gun and make it. But it became like 3 parts at once. And then he took it and threw out in the Riga near pass. In the meantime, Mahaprabhu came. Jagadananda Pandit first came. Oh, why is that dunder? Oh, dunder? I don't know dunder. Where dunder? I gave you? I don't remember. Oh, why he will give dunder to Mahaprabhu? And this dunder is here, in this river. Why you broke? Oh, I will. You should not bother for this. Mahaprabhu will come and I will reply him. Oh, after some time now. Where is my dunder? He was my life and soul of Aishwarya. Where is my dunder? Then Jagadananda told that. I gave it to Vishnu. And what he do, it, you can ask him. And he told, where is my dunder? And what is it? What is life? Oh, I think that, oh, I was having your dunder. And I was doing kirtan, I fell down and the dunder was broken. Oh, you were in mode and I was protecting, saving you and you fell down on that dunder and it was broken. Then Mahaprabhu becomes outwardly anger. Why it became? There is some teaching. We should not take one dunder. Dunder means three. To control our senses, bodies and mind. This dunder as a Narayan Swarup divided into three. One in four, in three. But also, jeev is added. Jeev prash. So actually there are three, but one is there also. So we should give our heart, tan, man, vachan. Our words, body, to Krishna. And by these things we serve Krishna. So we should give three. Also there is one thing. Krishna, his power, Radhika, and soul, serving them, are three. There are three also. Bhakti, Bhakta and Palman. What is in English? So, Mahaprabhu took it from any Shankaracharya Sampradaya, but he was also a devotee. We may take some in it, but we should follow the principle of Sampradaya. So, Nityananda Prabhu as a guru, not a dunder, or he made it. So, it is called. Mahaprabhu told that I cannot go with you. Either you should go further or I should go alone. They told that you should go forward. We will follow. So Mahaprabhu involved, he went to temple and he saw a beautiful Vrajendranandan Shyamsundar. He never saw and we see like wooden deity, big, big, round eyes, no arms, no feet, nothing. But he what saw? Oh, some float on him. It's fine. Look at the eyes, calling all Disha, peak of color. He never saw Jagannath, Baldev and Subhadra. But when he used to come in senses, then he may see that Jagannath, Deity and Baldev. So Krishna bhajan karta. And just thinking himself to be Radha, and he runs away towards the jewel prince. And in the meantime, he was checked by some devotee not to go forward, and he fell flat out of sense. Then in the meantime, Sarvam Bhattacharya, a very famous person, knowing all the tattvas, he saw that a young sannyasi, unknown, there are so many symptoms of high class of Mahabhava. They are read in Shastra. The symptom of prem, snehe, man, pranay, rag, anurag, bhav, mahabhav, adhirudha, all. So he saw that adhirudha, it cannot come in the body of any person, any jeev, even a soul. It can come only in the bodies of eternal associates of Krishna, especially who. Then who is he? He could not recover. But he saw the same thing. He never expected that these symptoms will be in any condition. So he was astonished to see. But he could not judge anything that who is. But he decided, yes, he must be any Mahabharata, not less than. And he ordered his persons, his followers, that you should carry this person, my horse. And he saw, he took some cotton and kept it on the in front of his nose. He saw that very some moment, but no sense at all. Or about more than so many hours, from morning to up to 3 o'clock in evening, no sense. Then in the meantime, Nityananda Prabhu and all came there, searching. They thought, Mahaprabhu, they became so much happy and so much dukhi kya gaya, sad also. Why? Oh, he is here. But whether he is dead or, but when they saw that, oh, something is there. Quickly they went to Jagannath and they took darshan and returned, and they began to chant, doing kirtan. Very loudly. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
After that again became started very loud. And after some time, he at once jumped, Mahaprabhu jumped. Hari Bol, Hari Bol,
Hari Bol,
Hari Bol.
They became happy. Then Sarvam Bhattacharya told, Mahaprabhu told that where? Where? Nityananda Prabhu and all talked with him. Then Sarvam Bhattacharya told that, now you should take bath and take to take some Mahaprasadam. And he thought somebody tells us Mahaprasadam from Jagannath temple. In the meantime, quickly Mahaprabhu passed the seat and returned back with his associates. And then, with his own hand, Sarvam Bhattacharya distributed Mahaprasad to him and his associates. Mahaprabhu told that only we used to give me Lapna Bhinja. Lapna Bhinja. Lapna means mix of vegetables, very simple. And gives sweets and tells us food too. But Sarvam Bhattacharya requested him, "Oh Prabhu, oh this is remnant of Jagannath. You should taste how he tastes. Or at least one time you should taste something." And thus Sarvam Bhattacharya, he told that, "Oh Gopinath, his brother-in-law, oh take him to this, my house, it is very nirjan, and he should take him." He took him, and then he met with Gopinath. What became of, when he returned, then Sarvam Bhattacharya asked his Shyalak, brother, that, "Do you know that boy, Sanyasi, new Sanyasi? Oh, I know that he is the son of Jagannath Mishra. Oh, Jagannath Mishra and Purandar. He is Purandar Mishra. And my, your father were called class fellow. And also the mother, the father of his mother, Nilamba Chakravarti. Oh, I know them all." So he is very good, very beautiful child. And I saw some symptoms. Oh, it cannot be in a general. He must be Mahabharata. But what told Gopinath? Do you remember what he told?
So, when Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya and Gopinathacharya, they were discussing, and Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, seeing the uncommon symptoms on the body of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then he asked, "Do you know who this person is?" And Gopinathacharya, he explained that yes, that he is son of Jagannath Mishra, Purandara, of Navadvip. And then Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, he exclaimed, "Oh, so he's son of Jagannath Mishra." That yes, I know Jagannath Mishra. In fact, I had very close relationship with Nilambar Chakravarti. So then Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, he also asked
that for his young sannyasi, how he can maintain his sannyasi? If he will read Vedanta with me, I can teach him. And after that, if he likes, I know that Bharati sannyasi are okay, but somewhat
lower.
So I can change his sannyas into higher degrees in one aranya
pretend to love
Gopinath. What he told? Then Gopinath Acharya, he explained that actually he's the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Yes.
So you're thinking that you can change his sannyas, but you don't understand who is this person. Then
he never cares for sannyas. For sannyas, he is always sinking in the ocean of love and affection. The Supreme Personality. But you are thinking him as a general person. You are wrong. See what happened? All his students began to cry. How is God personal?
Supreme Personality of Godhead.
How? You can prove?
So then, the students of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, Smara said, they started to laugh and they said, how you can prove that he is Supreme Personality of Godhead? They said that we accept things by anuman, by logic, by evidence. So then, Gopinath Acharya, then he explained that you cannot understand who is the Supreme Personality of Godhead by evidence. By this process, you cannot understand.
By your intelligence, you cannot understand. Then what is the process? Oh, the mercy of Supreme Personality. Only by that, we can realize who is God. He will himself forgive us. Again, what I do?
You said that, so Gopinath Acharya, he explained that you cannot understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead by logic or by your material intelligence or any
by
type
reading,
of...
By anything, by your intelligence. How we can know? If he is merciful and he sprinkles us merciful and he sent himself reveals himself, then you can. Then all students begin to laugh and Sarvam Bhattacharya told, oh, you should not waste time. We will see later on. You should go and bring some prasadam for children. Then he quickly went. After that, when Gopinath returned, oh, you will see. Then Sarvam Bhattacharya told to Gopinath, I want to teach him Vedanta. What is Vedanta? It is the essence of all Vedic literature, of all Upanishads, all kinds of knowledge, essence of all. It is collected by Srila Vyasadeva. And all our acharyas and ancient leaders, they followed it, accepted it. Those who don't know all these things, he cannot be acharya. So Ramanuj, Madhva, Vishnu, Swami, all explained and they have made bhashya for this. When they became acharya, so Bhattacharya was thinking that I should teach him this Vedanta to new sannyasi. Then Mahaprabhu came and he began to teach him Srimad Bhagavatam. Athato Brahma Jigyasa. Janma Adasya Jata, so many things. And he explained. How he explained? What he did? How? From beginning?
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he was very concerned about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He thought, oh, he's so young and so attractive, and how will he maintain the principles of sannyas? I must teach him, about Vedanta Sutra. So, without studying Vedanta Sutra, without acquiring gyan, knowledge of the conclusions of Vedanta, how can one be renounced from this world? He must be attracted by Maya. So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, out of his compassion for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he wanted to instruct him.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also accepted that you are like my father and guru.
He said, you are a learned scholar of Vedanta, so that you are the guru of all members of society. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is so humble, and he sat and he listened to the exposition of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya began to speak, explaining the meaning of Vedanta Sutra, but not the real meaning. He was explaining the commentary which has been written by Shankara Acharya. It's called Shariraka Bhasya. In this Shariraka Bhasya, it is explained that the absolute truth is Brahma. It is one. And we are all one with that Brahma. Brahma Satyam Jagan Mitya. Brahma is the absolute truth. And nothing but Brahma exists.
Brahma.
And Brahma. And
Brahma.
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 And this material world, oh, it does not exist. It is completely false. It is mithya, completely false. So he began to expound this philosophy. And the jiva, oh, you are not a person. You are not an individual. All are that one Brahma. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, very patiently, for hours, or not hours, for days, days and nights, 7 days and nights, continuously, he sat, oh, motionless, without moving, without any expression on his face. After speaking for 7 days, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
What were his more main points that this world is quietly false? We all, even crosses, mountains, rivers, creepers, trees, insects, birds, animals, all are actually Brahma. We are in Maya, so we are seeing all these things different from Brahma. Brahma has no shape, no attributes, no qualities at all. He has no power at all, without power. He is nirgun, niraka, no shape, no attributes. And we are ashamed. But he was explaining that athato brahma jigyasa janma dasya jata. What is the meaning? Janma dasya. All whole world has come. So how Vyasa has written this? If Brahma is nirgun, no power, no shape, nothing, no attribute, no power, then from where this world came, that we are seeing? We are not seeing that it is false. Our forefather Ram, Krishna, all came to this world. Are they false? Vedas are also in this world? Not even anything is false. So nothing. But we were then explaining. So all has come from where? There are two kinds of Brahma. One nirguna and other sub. No. Nirguna and sabun means, oh, covered with Maya, same Brahma is sabun. Covered. Or accepting Maya, he has become Brahma. And it is called sabun. But who is not covered with pure truth and pure Brahma? He has no shape, no attribute, no power, nothing, and he cannot create. So he was doing like so, telling like so, all these. Jivas are all Brahma, all are. But we see all. like so, for so many 7 days, there are more than 550. And he touched almost all the 7 sutras of Vedanta. Then, after 7 days, oh, are you understand something or not? If you are
understanding,
that your smile will smile your face. But it seems that I cannot imagine what you are doing. If you are understanding, then you will be happy. And then, oh, very good. And if not understanding, then you will tell that I am not understanding. Please explain. But for 7 days you are only looking and hearing. Why you are not speaking? Then what Mahaprabhu told? Oh, this sutra, condensed form of that Vedanta sutra. I am understanding and seeing like sun and its light. Everything is clear. I have no doubt. But when you explain the meaning, then it seems that like clouds you cover Vishnu. And that time I become so unhappy. I cannot tolerate these things. And we call that in this world that none to argue with me. Bhattacharya. Where you have doubt, he told. And what I am explaining is false or totally false. How? Then he explained. If a man has no desire, Brahma has no desire, no shape, no attribute, how we can create this? If all are Brahma, then why so many problems they are coming in birth, death, or waiting and so much, why it becomes? If world is false, then you are in false world and you are first false and foolish person. Why you are giving so much arguments? If world is false, yato mani bhutani jayanti jina jata. There are three things, but there are three things, adhikaran, sampradan and apadan. Means, oh, from Supreme Personality of Godhead, Brahma, Krishna, oh, everything has been created. Yato vanyani bhutani jayante, jena jatani, from whom all world is nourished, and they are all existent. And they lost all intercept. So there are three things you cannot understand because it is grammatical subject. And he proved that what you told, all things is false. If all the beings are Brahma, then why they are suffering so much? Why? How they were departed from him? Why? He told, oh, by two things. One, the reflection, Pratibimbabhava. And next, Sukti in Rajak, Rajak. Everything is Brahma, but we are Sukti. Who are you? Mahaprabhu question. Who are you? I am Brahma. Then, all are, why not seeing this thing? That all are suffering? Why they came in this world? Why we are separated from Brahma? He could not answer. Shut. Mahaprabhu cut it, all he wants. About 3-4 hours, he cut all the arguments. And then he became astonished. Who is he? And in the meantime, he told one Shloka Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Atma Ramasya Muneo, Tapi Guru Kraman, Purvanta Haitukim Bhaktim Ittam Bhoda. Oh, Supreme Personality of God is not selfless, not attributeless, he is not powerful. He has very beautiful shape. He is so sweet, he is so beautiful, attracting all, even to all beings, deers and all. He is Brahma. He can make others also very high by giving his breath. That is why he is called Brahma. Any jiva cannot be Brahma. In even pure state, they can suck. This world is not false. It may be temporary. But the world is coming from whom? From Brahma coming, and it will remain all lives and lives. Only we think that we are this body. We are not Brahma. So when he was defeated, then he told that I want to hear the meaning of this sloka, Atmaram. Even Atmaram, who serving Brahma, Nirgun Brahma, by his qualities and beautiful say, they are attractive. And he gave Sanatan, Sanak Sanandar, Sanatan, and Sukadeva Goswami, and then it at once explained it. He told to him, you should explain. He explained in 9 ways. And Mahaprabhu, not taking his any explanation, he explained in 18. And to Sanatana Goswami he explained in 64. Oh, and he is not a man. And when he thought that he is not a man, then at once Mahaprabhu was very much merciful to him. And he showed his Chaturbhuj Roopa, Shankh Chakra Gada Padma, at first. And then he said, oh, he is Narayan. And after a moment, he chanted and he took the shape of 6 hands. 4 Chaturbhuj and 4, 2, and then. Then, oh, in the final stage, oh, he is Supreme Personality. From he has created me. And he has so much attributes, very beautiful thing. And he played flat on the lotus feet of. Next day, Mahaprabhu went to see Jagannath. And then, in the very morning, at 4, when Thakurji arrived, Mangal Arati. Oh, Pujari gave him Mahaprabhu some prasadam and one god. He took in his Bahirbash, Uttari, and he bent it. And he just came in the house of Sarvam. Oh, same time he woke. And what telling? Krishna, Krishna. He never told, he told first time. And he saw that how Mahaprabhu is there. And Mahaprabhu gave him mercifully that prasadam to him. And he was at first Brahmavadi and Satkarmi like. He never took prasad like this. And now he began to pray. He had not even washed his mouth and anything. And he at once took and he prayed that if even prasad is rotten, touched by dog, mouth, rotten animal brought from any far away, but still we should be at one, like Brahma. Mahaprasad is Mahaprasade Govinde Nama Brahmani Vaishnavi Shalp Punmata Vishwas. General person, they cannot have so much belief on Mahaprasad, on name, the associates of Krishna and Mahaprasad. Very fortunate person they can. Otherwise not. So we have to keep very strong faith on Mahaprasadam, his name, his associates, Nama Brahmani, Vaishnava also. Oh, they are not mortal. Oh, they are what? Constant. And then the mercy of him. Then he, Mahaprabhu, became very happy. And I am so fortunate that how you are changed. Oh, before you were like crows, always doing what? Kaw, kaw, kaw. You know? Here crow, crow? Crows. Black. Bird. Yes, dog. And now you are, oh, like a peacock or cocoa bird. Very sweet. Krishna, Krishna, like you are. So you are now very fortunate. And next day, Sarvam Bhattacharya sent some Mahaprasadam from anyone. And a letter to Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu took it, and this letter, first it was went in the hands of Mukunda, his associate. Mukunda was very intelligent. He wrote this slope on the wall and then sent it to Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu read it, and at once he, what was there? The two shloka of Mahaprabhu, Pranam Mantra. You can see. Vairagya yuga bhakti, na vairagya vidyanija bhakti yoga sikshatameka purusham purana Sri Krishna Chaitanya sharira namadhari. And one more. Yes. That you are same Parabrahma, not other than Krishna, Supreme Personality of God. My mind, my heart, my tongue, everything should be like a Brahmas means bubble, and always attract to these, always taking the juice of flowers like juice of Krishna name and Krishna. So Mahaprabhu told it. But Mukunda was so clever, intelligent, so wrote, and all the began to remember this issue, always remember. So after this,
Vairagya Vijanija Bhakti Yoga Shikshat Mekha Purusha Purana Shri Krishna Chaitanya Shreya Dhari Vipapuni Yasta Mahamprabhade. Let me take shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Shri Krishna, who has descended in the form of Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to teach us real knowledge, his devotional service, and detachment from whatever does not foster Krishna consciousness. He has descended because he is an ocean of transcendental mercy. Let me surrender unto his lotus feet. Kalanna stambhakti yoga nijam yaha pradus pradum krishna chaitanya nama avibhutas tasya padara vinde karam daram liya sam chitta bringaha. Let my consciousness, which is like a honey bee, take shelter of the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who has just now appeared as Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to teach the ancient system of devotional service to himself. This system had almost been lost due to the influence of time.
Okay. should know that by intelligence we can adjust that he is devotee, his supreme personality of Godhead, or what is bhakti by intelligence. By whom? By high philosophy, association, we can hear, and then by this process, by the mercy of devotees and by the mercy of himself, supreme personality, we can judge this. You should know, even the last fraction of bhakti, that is called shraddha, is transcendent. Not
speculation of mind.
Not complete. You cannot know all this. So it has been written in Gaudiya Katha that Guru na shashya, Swajano na shashya. पिता न सस्यात् जननी न सस्यात् दैवं न सस्यात् पति च सस्यात् न मोति दर्शनम्. गुरु इज नॉट गुरु और ही कैन टेक सम मनी एंड चीट यू, सो दीज आर नॉट गुरु, दे आर फॉलन. ए गुरु मस्ट, इफ ए गुरु, गुरु इज नॉट गुरु, father is not father, mother is not mother, oh, pati, husband is not husband, wife is not wife. If she is not giving bhakti and taking over all kinds of problems, sorrow, even death and birth, those who can take this, really he is. Otherwise not. That is why it has been told, if he is very much learned person in Ved, Upanishad, Bhagavad, Gita, everything, but he has no realization of Krishna, no bhakti of Krishna, he is not Puri, he is Avaishnava. We should try to, if by chance you have done, when you are ignorant and you accepted anyone as a guru, but later on you saw, what? Jiva Goswami is telling here, if you have accepted anyone as a guru, but if he is Vaishnava Vidveshi, envious to any Vaishnava, true Vaishnava, then he should be given. At once, without a delay, faith. Because we cannot achieve bhakti from him, he is offender, so we should give up. And we should try to accept, oh, very qualified and knowing all these things, having bhakti, and we should accept any guru. If there are good guru, family guru, or anyone, but we see that he cannot give us bhakti, then we should give. But if a devotee, his bhakta, he has bhakti, but not so much a scholar and no realization. He is like Madhyamadhikari, but he is very generous and. But he cannot answer and he cannot remove our whole doubts. Then what should we do? Then take permission that I want to have a shiksha guru, more elevated. Please allow. And he must allow. And if he is not allowing, then what? Oh, give up. At once. Understand? If you are not doing, bhakti will not come. If you have done ignorantly, accepted any guru, but he is very fond of wealth, reputation, not chanting, not having bhakti, then what should we do? No need of taking permission. No need. What to do? Oh, we should reject that. And where bhakti will be received, we should accept it. Otherwise, bhakti will not be there. So, Jiva Goswami totally tell. If anyone assumes that he is devotee, chanting, remembering, also taking tilak, but he is so much envious to any pure devotee, then he is avaishnava. Guru Rapi Avalit Dasya, Karja Karja Majana. He is not Guru. He has no intelligence to pick up what is good and what is bad. So he should be rejected. So, Mahabhagavatam, you should accept as a Guru or Shiksha Guru, yes, and go on. Then you will have bhakti. Otherwise, not. Those who have not the wealth of bhakti in their heart, how can they be? So we should try to select a guru. We should try to accept a guru who can give us prema bhakti. He is not attached to worldly things, sense gratification, who has no requirement for money or anything like this. He can change us. He can give bhakti. So we should try. So, we see in Mahaprabhu all disciples, in his successors, all acharyas. Someone big, like Shyamananda, he has a guru, very bona fide guru, but he was not so much realized. Then he came to Jiva Goswami and he asked his Gurudev. Happily his Gurudev ordered that you can be there and you should be in that association. And then with Shaman Nartam Thakur and Shaman Bhagavad, where taught all these things by Jiva Goswami. Thus, when after this, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to go to Sava. Can you tell what Mahaprabhu left Puri only with Kala Krishna Das? And he went first to Kurmachal. And what became there? You remember something? Do you remember? Huh? He went to Kurmachal. You remember?
Lord Chaitanya went to the house of Kurma Brahmana. And that Brahmana washed the Lord's lotus
feet. Oh, more something. Prior to this. You cannot tell. You remember something? Who remember? You? Oh, yes, or this? Thank you. You have much more time. You can read more. And you should know all these things. Then your mind will be observed.
Omagyana Tibrandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshun Militam Jina Tasmai Shri Guru Vedi Maha.
Shamshan? Shamshan? Yes. So you should be ready.
So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, on his tour to South India, he came to one Brahmin's home, named the Kurma Brahmin. This was after delivering the great soul Vasudev leper, as Prabhupada describes, Vasudev Thakur. The members of Kurma Brahman's household, they bathed, the Kurma Brahman bathed Lord Chaitanya's lotus feet and they sprinkled the remnants, they charanamritam. The members of his family relatives, friends, and kids enjoy. Then they cooked a wonderful feast for Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And with love and affection, they made Lord Chaitanya eat all the foodstuffs, and they distributed the temperance to all the family members and friends present there. At that point, the Karma Brahmana felt compelled to beg the Lord, "My dear Lord, I can no longer tolerate the waves of misery caused by materialistic life. Please take me with you." And at that point, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu replied, "No, do not speak like this again. Better to remain at home and always chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and engage your family members in this Krishna Gita. Yare te gatahe kaha Krishna Upadesh Amara Agaya Uduhantara Ige. That instruct everyone in the science of Krishna consciousness by reading and understanding the Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavad Gita, and Srimad Bhagavatam. This way become a guru and deliver everyone in this land." And I was hearing Srila Prabhupada one lecture before I came here. And Prabhupada said that it is not difficult to be guru, but one has to be qualified. And he said, meaning the Siksha Guru, that one should, and this I'm thinking in terms of on behalf of Srila Gurudev, that wherever we are situated, whatever our Prabhudatta Desh, wherever we find our place of residence given by our beloved spiritual master, we should make that place of Krishna consciousness. We should provide a shelter for the conditioned souls to hear and chant the glories of the Lord and engage in these six loving exchanges that Srila Prabhupada, Srila Gurudev, Srila Rupa Goswami are imploring us to engage. Yeah. Because this way the conditioned souls may have a chance to meet the bona fide spiritual master and begin their spiritual life. So this pastime is very wonderful because we've all come to Krishna consciousness by great fortune.
Thank you. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came in Kulmachi. Oh, less and less the devotees assembled to take darshan of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu has no time and always shouting to take darshan of Mahaprabhu. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, time to time, he was 2-3 days there, and time to time he used to give darshan. Also, there was so much crowd that a Brahmin, whose name was Vasudeva, but he had leprosy, top to bottom. You know leprosy? So many insects. Oh, very hookworm. Oh, fat. Oh, white. Oh, long. And he wanted to take darshan of Mahaprabhu. But he was fearing also not to come in crowd because all were hating. So he was out of crowd some far away. But he was always, "Oh Krishna, oh Krishna." And when insects were coming from out of his body, he used to take again and put in the heels. So, "Oh, why you are going there? You will starve and you will die. So be placed here and take my blood and all these things. Or don't go there." And he was chanting, "Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna." But he wanted to take a glance of darshan of Mahaprabhu. But he could not come. And Mahaprabhu in the meantime left that place. And he went towards south. When he went about 4 miles, 5 miles, 6 miles, 8 miles, all in boat, Krishna, 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 Krishna. At once this Vasudev Vipra coined bitterly, "Oh Krishna, I could not take darshan of Mahaprabhu. Supreme Personality of Godhead, he came, I cannot touch him, cannot talk him, I have no his mercy, and thus I am unfortunate." When Mahaprabhu was there, he at once heard, and at once, in a moment, he came at once, and he embraced that Roshi. So in many insects were there, but when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu embraced, at once in a moment, he became very beautiful like demigods. Very beautiful and very good. Then he began to cry, "Oh Prabhu, what are you doing? Now I am looking so beautiful. Now I will be proud and my bhakti will go. So please make me as I was." Mahaprabhu told that. "Now Maya will not touch you. You should chant and repent for all this Krishna. So no false ego will come to you and you will be like Guru." And yes, what he told after that, we met a Brahmin. I will explain it tomorrow. Go, Ramar.
Hari Hari Bo.
Anyone was telling that they will do Kirtan?